Hello, my name is Dr. Rajiv Bendale. I'm with SAIC. I am a Chief Solutions Architect with the SDG Group. Today, I'd like to talk to you about making the case for high-performance computing, code modernization, and optimization for emerging HPC architectures. Lately, advances in computer architectures have been in the news, with AMD being poised to deliver the first exascale computer system to the DOE at Oak Ridge National Labs. The new wave of processors at the heart of these HPC systems show a trend going back towards high core count per processor. This is very similar to what we saw Intel do with their many-core Xeon Phi platform in the past. We can expect more variation in processor architectures show up in HPC systems. With the recent introduction of a variety of new processors such as Intel's Xeon second generation scalable processors, AMD's EPYC, Marvel's Thunder X2, IBM's Power 10, and NVIDIA's Turing-based GPUs. These variants emphasize the need for application porting, optimization, and tuning for best performance on these particular hardware platforms. These processors come with a host of new features such as AMD's chiplet processor design with on-die 3D stacked memory architectures that require code changes to make effective use of these features. The compute servers also have new components such as fast solid-state disk drives and new technologies like Intel's Optane DC persistent memory, DRAM. This is pin compatible with DDR4 DIMMs. This is making its way into servers in form of DIMMs to be used as tiered burst buffer memory in sizes large as 512 gigabyte modules. So technologies such as these create an obvious pressure for applications, both HPC and non-HPC in nature, to be modernized, refactored, and or optimized and tuned for these next generation hardware designs. Now, having a large amount of RAM and burst buffer memory are forcing a new way of thinking about data structures, data arrays, and data objects in memory and their use within HPC. So let's look at what is at stake in code optimization. Traditional HPC codes are more than a few years old in their current state and are not directly capable of taking advantage of the new processor features, such as memory advances, high-speed interprocessor bus architectures, or to work at the peak efficiency on these new platforms. Now, unchanged HPC applications in the past managed to eke out a very modest performance increase, relying solely on higher processor speeds at each processor refresh, and of course, better compilers. This is no longer possible with the end of Moore's law and Dennard scaling. So increasing the number of processors is pushing things like OpenMP programming to the forefront. Now consider that nearly all HPC installations follow a 3 to 5 year technology upgrade or a refresh cycle. So inevitably, the HPC code will require modernization within a shorter time span today. Running unchanged HPC codes on the latest architectures does not always result in performance increase, despite advances in compiler technology, and in many cases, yields a lower code performance on new architectures. All of these factors make the case for HPC code modernization and optimization. In SAIC's experience, based on our expertise in HPC code modernization, we typically see anywhere from a 1.2-fold to a 10-fold, if not higher, speed up factor with many HPC codes. Obviously, this depends on the code and the problem class, such as, you know, either weak or strong scaling, amongst other considerations. Now, if the code is run as is on new architectures, we obviously waste resources due to code inefficiency, and we incur a penalty in cost and energy consumed. We can think of this in terms of a carbon footprint associated with HPC computing for each application run. So, improving the efficiency of the code results in lower costs and obviously a lower carbon footprint, something to look out for. A point worth noting is that, so far, refactoring the HPC codes to accommodate these architectures has created development and maintenance headaches in managing the multiple branches of codes for each architecture variant. These efforts significantly tax the developers and maintainers of the codes. This requires a significant investment in software expertise in multiple architecture platforms and the added burden of verification and validation as each new generation of hardware and compilers and computing environments present themselves. So how do we ensure that HPC codes will keep up with advances in the hardware? Well, one way is to start the code transformation process early and attempt to accommodate the widest possible architecture variances. This is a hard task. SAIC has developed a host of best practices for such HPC code modernization tasks. Some of the successful approaches we have developed and applied on contracts serving the US government include, for example, creating modular code architecture, applying hardware abstractions where possible, adopting new data structures to accommodate hardware such as GPGPUs, refreshing numerical algorithms with newer scalable ones, exploring data movement sparing algorithms that are necessary for extreme scale parallelism, making greater use of scientific libraries and modularization of code for portability and efficiency. Now, all such elements contribute towards creating a maintainable code base that can be sustained for a longer time frame into the future. We also explore the possibility of rewriting legacy HPC codes in newer programming languages. For example, transforming Fortran 77 code to Fortran 2019 or C++ 17, which are newer versions of languages. If applications are targeted for extreme scale, we also explore adopting runtime and task-based parallelism approaches. This implies that resources are available for a complete code rewrite. And knowing the cost, this might only be possible in a case of very few mission-critical codes. Creating a largely hardware-agnostic code base addresses the risk in new technology adoption and is a viable risk mitigation strategy. These approaches pose the question of what specialized skill sets are required to address the issue of code transformation and optimization. Well, now given the rapidly changing landscape of HPC architectures, it is clear that it is incrementally more difficult for domain specialist developers to keep up with the rapid pace of hardware and software innovation. It demands frequent updates and optimization of codes for maximum efficiency and scalability on new test and production hardware. So how does one tackle this challenge? At SAIC, we have learned from our work on NOAA, Department of Defense, and Department of Energy contracts that it makes good practical sense to have a computer scientist work together with a domain specialist. They jointly work on new codes to refactor, optimize, and scale legacy codes for new architectures. So here, the computer scientist keeps up with the latest knowledge of hardware architecture and software engineering skills. The domain specialist develops new physics-based models without the overhead burden of keeping up with deep computing hardware knowledge. The combined expertise of the computer scientist with the domain scientist's knowledge for physics-based modeling embodied in the HPC codes now provides a happy medium for obtaining the best efficiency in adapting the HPC codes to these platforms. This allows for an easier approach to modularizing HPC codes with HPC frameworks and hardware abstractions to ensure that the codes will be operable, maintainable, and sustainable far into the future. Other newer challenges we see come from a push to adopt new emerging technologies like machine learning to enhance the science and engineering insights from HPC codes. Well, some examples are the use of machine learning techniques to help reduce the parameter space in optimization problems. So a specific case is the use of machine learning to enhance parameterization and the performance of existing climate and weather prediction models with the direct application of pattern detection to identify early onset of cyclonic or hurricane activity and other extreme weather events. Other areas of new technology adoption that is emerging is the use of HPC in the cloud, with many of the cloud vendors supporting the latest HPC architectures. Overall, all of these emerging technologies present interesting challenges to our HPC codes, and they highlight the need for a new approach to HPC code modernization, modularization, and optimization. So with that, I hope I have made a strong case for the push to modernizing our HPC codes to accommodate the new architectures that are coming down the road. Thank you.